Now let's talk about the laminar boundary layer. So what is this all about? So for that, let us assume we have a plate, all right, and you have a rear fluid which is flowing in that direction. And the mean stream, or you can say the free stream velocity of this fluid is capital U. So when this fluid is in touch with this leading edge, the boundary layer starts to form. So the layer which is just next to the plate will have its velocity zero, and as you start going away from the plate, the velocity gradients are set up. Okay, we have seen this in the previous video. Now the region of the boundary layer in this much, or you can say which is very close to the leading edge, is laminar. So this will have a laminar flow, this much region from A to B. So this we can call the laminar zone. Alright, so till B you will have a laminar kind of a flow within the boundary layer, and as you keep on going further away from the leading edge, this boundary layer, it keeps on growing. So the boundary layer size keeps on growing as you start going away from the leading edge. Now why is this so? Okay, this is because the retardation effect of the shear stresses produced in the boundary layer keeps on increasing as we keep on going away. So the fluid is retarded much, you know, you can say the retardation of the fluid increases as you go away from the leading edge. So this is the laminar zone. Then from B to C you have a transition zone which is from laminar to turbulent, and this becomes the turbulent zone. Okay, now if you talk about this part or this point B, up till point B you have the laminar flow, or the boundary layer is laminar in nature. So if you talk about the Reynolds number, which is the number which governs whether your flow is laminar or turbulent, so for a plate the laminar flow Reynolds number should be this much, not more than this. So the distance up to which your flow would be laminar is governed by this equation. This is the Reynolds number, which is u into x upon nu. So u is the free stream velocity, x is the distance away from the leading edge up till which your flow would remain laminar. Okay, and nu is the kinematic viscosity of the fluid. Now if your x is at such a distance such that the Reynolds number increases, this value goes up by 5 into 10 to the power 5, then you would enter into the transition zone and finally you will go into the turbulent zone. Okay, so this is something that you need to remember and understand, that is very close or just at the leading edge the boundary layer starts to form. The layer of the fluid just in the vicinity of the plate is at zero velocity. So this is called the no slip condition. As you keep on going further away from the leading edge, the boundary layer size keeps on increasing and the flow starts getting you can say transformed from laminar into the transition zone, and then it goes into the turbulent zone. Okay, and this is the formula with the help of which we can find out the distance from the leading edge up till which the flow would be laminar. So I hope you got this. Now let's move on to the next video and talk about the boundary layer thickness.